Welcome everybody, my name is Ankit Patel and today we are going to study about cell cycle, right? Cell cycle is the process in which whole lifespan of cell get covered, right? Right from the formation of cell till the division of cell, right? That is time period between two successive cell divisions, right? Where in daughter, at the first cell division, daughter cell forms, right? This daughter cell will grow and it will grow into a fully developed cell, right? Where this cell now become mother cell and it will divide into two daughter cells, right? So this whole lifespan, this whole duration is of cell cycle, right? Here cell cycle starts from formation of daughter cell till division, till it become mother cell and division of it, right? So this whole duration covers up in cell cycle, right? Now for a daughter cell to grow into mother cell, there are certain processes that should occur, right? For that is growth of cell, right? Formation of all the cytoplasmic content and nuclear content before it undergoes division, right? Then DNA replication should occur, right? There should be double copy of DNA, there should be two copies of DNA molecules before it undergoes division, so that each copy get distributed to two daughter cell, right? So all this process should occur during this cell cycle, and how this occurring and at which time all these processes are occurring, we will study in cell cycle, right? Again, there are fixed duration for certain cells to complete its cell cycle, that is to complete lifespan of a cell. For in human, not all cells are dividing, not all cells undergo division, but some cells are undergoing division, and this division have duration of life cycle, means duration between each two consecutive cell cycle for those kind of cells which are undergoing division in humans is 24 hours, right? That is, in 24 hours each cells get double into, I mean each cells will get divided into two cells, right? The whole cell cycle will complete right from the growth of cell till the division of cell. Whole this processes get completed in 24 hours in human, in those cells which are undergoing, which can undergo division process, right? Due to this cell cycle or due to this division process, human or any other organisms can grow. Unicellular organisms can reproduce, and we in multicellular organisms repair mechanism is also occurring due to this cell division. Understood? So cell division is very crucial and essential process, right? In each like unicellular organism, cell cycle get completes in 90 minutes, right? It takes just 90 minutes, and even shorter in E. coli cell, the doubling time is 20 minutes. So the whole cell cycle get complete in 20 minutes. Understood? So this is cell cycle of humans, that is of 24 hours, then of yeast, that is 90 minutes, and E. coli is, that is of 20 minutes, right? So in this time, these are the different time spans for cell cycle in different organisms, right? Depending on how complex the cells are. Understood? The whole cell cycle is divided into two phases, that is interphase and end phase, right? So the whole cell cycle is divided into two phases, this is called in end phase, and this much duration will be there for interphase, right? So there are two phases, interphase and end phase. End phase means mitotic phase, as cell division is occurring, and there are two types of cell division, we know that mitosis and meiosis, and most of the time this mitosis is occurring, so that's why this phase is also called mitosis phase. Understood? So there are two phases, interphase and mitosis phase. This is the phase in which cells are undergoing division, right? Mother cells will divide into two daughter cells. One mother cell will divide into two daughter cells, right? And remaining duration of cell cycle is called interphase, right? It is called interphase, right? Now, if we talk about human cells, almost 1 hour is, in a 24 hour, only 1 hour is taken by mitosis phase. We know that cell cycle of human cells which are undergoing division, which can undergo division, are taking is taking 24 hours to complete its cell cycle. So in a whole cell cycle, this N phase is taking just 1 hour or just 5% of all the cell duration of all the duration which is covered by cell cycle, right? And remaining 95% of the time duration is consumed by interphase in human cells which are undergoing cell division. Understood? So almost 95% of time is taken by interphase, and just 5% time is consumed by mitosis phase in a lifespan of a cell. Understood? To complete its life cycle, right? That is during the from the formation till the division. Understood? Okay. Including division also, right? Till the formation, from the formation till completion of division of cell. Understood? So this whole process is called cell cycle. This whole duration or this whole process that is occurring in this is called a cell cycle, right? In which there are two phases, right? Now this interphase is again divided into three phases. They are G1 phase, S phase, and G2 phase, right? As I have given here larger area and some very smaller area and bit larger area over here, that is depending on how much time duration is taken by each of these phase, right? G1 phase takes longest duration, right? It is called, G1 stands for gap 1 phase, but it is also called as growth phase, right? Wherein cell growth is occurring, and that's why it is taking longest time in whole cell cycle, right? It is gap 1 phase, and it is also called growth phase, where cell cytoplasmic content is increasing. Cytoplasmic content means here chemicals present in it, water content, all this content is increasing. Daughter cells are smaller in size, while after G1 phase their sizes increases, right? Okay, so this is about G1 phase. Now in S phase, duplication of DNA molecule is occurring, wherein from one copy of DNA at the beginning of S phase there will be only one copy of DNA, but till the end of S phase there will be two copy of DNA molecules, right? Now just remember here that there is no doubling of chromosome numbers, right? Number of chromosomes remains same, but DNA content becomes double, right? How this thing is occurring? That is, at the beginning of S phase, chromosomes are 2C type, right? Chromosomes are 2C type, right? But at the end of S phase, these chromosomes are of 4C type. Understood? So that is how DNA content get double. In each chromosome, DNA content get double, right? So number of chromosomes does not get changed, but yes, mass of chromosomes get double. Understood? Why? How? Because earlier it is 2C chromosome and now it is 4C chromosome in S phase. Understood? Again, if it is animal cell, then centrioles in cytoplasm will also duplicate and there will be two centrosomes in S phase in animal cell. Means during completion of S phase in animal cell. Understood? Which are really required, which are very essential for mitosis phase, that is cell division phase, right? That is cell division. Understood? Now, after S phase comes G2 phase. This G2 phase is also very important because in G2 phase, whatever the proteins, whatever the enzymes or RNA molecules that are required for the process to carry out mitosis is forming in G2 phase, right? It is called, G2 stands for gap 2 phase. Understood? So gap 2 phase, all these phases are important, G2 is also important, right? It is producing all the proteins, that is protein which are required in spindle fiber formation, in ester formation, all this, and all those enzymes which are required in N phase, mitosis or in cell division, all those enzymes will be forming over here. RNA molecules that are required, all of them are forming in G2 phase. Understood? That is gap 2 phase. Understood? Then cell is undergoing mitosis, in which mitosis is again divided into two parts. That is, one is called One is called karyokinesis and another one is called cytokinesis, right? So in M phase, again there are two processes, that is karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyo means nucleus, right? And kinesis means division. Understood? So it is karyokinesis means division of nucleus. And similarly, cyte means cell. Understood? And kinesis means again division. So it is division of cells. Cytokinesis means cell is undergoing division. Understood? So remaining part of cell, because nucleus has already divided, right? So remaining part of cell or cytoplasm here get divided, right? And that is how, when these two processes are completed, M phase get completed, right? And division get over, and again these daughter cells will undergo G1 phase. So that is how whole cell cycle is carried out. Understood? And again, for all these processes, there are two checkpoints. Yes, there are two checkpoints. Now, what are those two checkpoints? One checkpoint is present over here. One checkpoint is present over here. And another checkpoint is present over here. Understood? So, there are two checkpoints which are... These two checkpoints are regulated by cyclin CDK complexes, right? Cyclin CDK complexes, right? In both of these checkpoints, there are two different type of cyclins. This here, the cyclin which is required is called G1 cyclin, and cyclin which is required here is called mitotic cyclin, right? The cyclin which helps in transition of cell from G1 phase to S phase is called G1 cyclin, and cyclin that will help in transition of cell to transform from G2 phase to N phase is called mitotic cyclin. Understood? So there are these two cyclin. Now cyclin alone cannot do any process, right? So this cyclin get bind to CDK molecule, right? Now what is this CDK molecule? Now, name of cyclin is there because it is helping in carrying out cell cycle process, right? So the word cyclin comes from cycle. Understood? Now, what is CDK? CDK full form is cyclin dependent kinase. Understood? Now, first of all, I would like to discuss about kinase. What is meaning of kinase? Kinase means the type of enzyme which is carrying out phosphorylation type of process, right? All the kinases are the enzymes which are carrying out phosphorylation type of process. Phosphorylation process means addition of phosphate group, right? It means addition of phosphate group. So it means they are adding PO4 ion to certain type of molecules, right? So this CDK is actually an enzymatic chemical which is helping in phosphorylating of certain molecules. But this CDK remains in inactive form. So when it get active, when it will bind with cyclin, that's why it is called cyclin dependent kinase. Understood? That's why it is called cyclin dependent kinase. That means it totally depend on bound of cyclin. That is, when it can bind with cyclin, then only it can do phosphorylation process, right? So what is happening when cell, when the growth is completed, when G1, all those processes which is occurring in G1 phase, when this completed and cell is ready to get transformed into S phase, at that time G1 cyclin is forming. Understood? At that time G1 cyclin is forming, and this G1 get bind with CDK protein, and here formation of heterodimer cyclin CDK is occurring, right? Now why it is called heterodimer? Dimer means it is a complex which is made up of two monomers, right? Dimer means it is made up of two monomers. And why it is called heterodimer? Because both of the monomers are of different type, right? One is cyclin and another one is cyclin dependent kinase. So both of these proteins are different, and this to get bind with each other, right? And lead to formation of cyclin CDK complex. That is what is called heterodimer, right? Now this cyclin CDK complex is activated enzyme, right? It is carrying out catalyzing activity of certain molecules which gets phosphorylated by this cyclin CDK complex, right? There are some molecules which get phosphorylated by the enzymatic action of cyclin CDK complex, which lead to occurrence of certain other chemical reactions in their sequence, right? So it is like if A get converted into B, then in the influence of B, now A cannot convert C to D. But if A is converted to B and D is activated form, so B can convert C into D. Understood? Let me show you. It is like A is inactivated form. A is inactivated form. So A get converted into B. Now D is activated form, right? So under the influence of activated B, this B will convert C into D. Now C is again inactive form, but D is active form. Under the influence of B, C got activated in its D form, that is in its activated form, right? Now under the influence of D, there will be conversion of inactivated E into activated F. Understood? So there are cascade of chemical reactions which is occurring due to phosphorylation activity of cyclin CDK complex. Understood? And which ultimately leads to transition of cell from its G phase to S phase. Understood? So that is how this regulation is occurring, right? Again, in this checkpoint. From G2 to N phase, there is one more cyclin. When all the processes of G2 get completed and cell is ready to come in M phase, here formation of mitotic cyclin is occurring, right? Here formation of mitotic cyclin is occurring. And this mitotic cyclin get bind with CDK, right? This mitotic cyclin get bind with CDK complex, CDK, right? That is cyclin dependent kinase. Again, the same CDK which is present over there. Understood? It will bind with CDK. But now here cyclin is another cyclin. Here not G1 cyclin is not there. Here mitotic cyclin is there, which will help in transition of cell from G2 phase to M phase. Understood? So it is depending on which kind of cyclin is there, transition of cell will occur. Understood? So here mitotic cyclin is there. So there will be transition of cell from G2 to M phase. Understood? Now this mitotic cyclin get bind with CDK, again CDK molecule, the same CDK which was there only, right? Same type of CDK molecule it is binding with, and which will again lead to phosphorylation of certain chemicals, and this phosphorylation activity is carrying out this kind of sequential cascade of chemical reactions. Understood? And which ultimately lead to transition of cell from its G2 phase to M phase. Now this cell is ready to undergo division process. Understood? And that is how this regulation is carried out. So there are two process, there are two transition states, that is from G1 to S and G2 to M. This cyclin CDK regulation is there, which is really, really very important for NEET point of view, that is medical entrance, right? It is not there in our textbook, but it is really very important for NEET point of view. Understood? After the cell comes in M phase, when it came in M phase, here chromosome, all the chromosomes that are present in cell is in 4C form, right? It is in 4C form, but now it will get converted into, after the division, after completion of division, it have converted into 2C chromosome, right? Now one thing I will make you clear that here during in interphase DNA is not present in form of chromosome, right? Here I have shown you the chromosome, right? That is I have shown in that way that if here chromatin fiber get converted into chromosome, then it will become 2C chromosome, right? And at this point if chromatin fiber get converted into chromosome, it will become 4C chromosome. So here actually 4C chromosome is not there, here 2C chromosome is not there, but it is here what is there, chromatin fiber, both of this from here, from around here to here, chromatin fiber are present, right? Chromosome is present only in M phase, right? That we have discussed when we are discussing nucleus. But this is in the way that if chromatin fiber, somehow chromatin fiber get converted into chromosome during this transition state, then it will form 2C chromosome, right? And if chromatin fiber get converted into chromosome in S phase, which is actually not occurring, right? Then it will form 4C chromosome, right? What I want to say is here, chromosome numbers are, if chromosome will form, then chromosome number will same. But here DNA chromatin material is doubled, DNA content is doubled, mass of chromosome is doubled, right? If chromosome will form here, right? Which is not actually occurring. Understood? But in M phase, there is at the beginning of M phase, there is formation of chromosome and it is of 4C. When this division get completed, this chromosome, these two are called sister chromatids that we have already discussed in nucleus topic, right? These two are called sister chromatids of each other. That is, this one is a sister chromatid and this is another sister chromatid, right? And they are called sister chromatids of each other. Understood? So both of these sister chromatids get separated during M phase in two different daughter cells, and in each cell all chromosomes become 2C, right? Which is actually there in the cells, right? Now again, after the end of M phase, this chromosome get converted, again this chromosome will get converted into chromatin material as cell have entered interphase. Understood? So this is also very important to remember that during mitosis phase, DNA is present in the form of chromosome, and in interphase, DNA is present in the form of chromatin material. Understood? But this is, I have shown you to make you understand that chromosome number doesn't get doubled, but chromatin material or DNA content get doubled, or if chromosome can form here, which is not actually occurring, then mass of these chromosomes get doubled after this S phase. Understood, everybody? Thank you very much for watching video. If you really like the video, share it to your friends as well. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not subscribed yet, and press the bell icon for notifications as I'm uploading videos on daily basis except Saturday and Sunday. So goodbye for now.